Hello friends, I am Yashpal Rathod, an HDSA nature photographer based out of Bangalore, India. And today in this video, I am going to walk you through our camera safety case used for camera trap photography. Our camera safety case is built around IP67 waterproof enclosure for maximum protection of for your camera and lens against natural elements like rain, snow, dust. It is fully weatherproof and housing compatible for any of your DSLR mirrorless camera. There is enough space that you can mount wireless flash transmitter on a hot shoe. Except few large square bodies like Canon 1DX series or Nikon D5 D6 series, most of the camera can easily accommodate. As you can see, we have a seat lens opening in the front, and I use a red kind of cap in the front with a 95mm UV coated filter, and the lens and this thread has around 1.5 inch variable lens, so it can accommodate lenses of length of 80mm to the 125mm. So this gives us a flexibility when we use different lens. Also, since we can remove it, so when we are traveling, we can take it out and can keep it inside so it filter doesn't get damaged. Also, we have provided a grooves here where I have made a polycarbonate hood which can just slide in, and it will protect your front element against the dust water. So this is, as soon as you receive this camera case, just take a measurement of this hood and keep it handy, because these hoods are the one which mostly get damaged easily in the field by the animals, and they can be easily fabricated by a foam board or the cardboard and like that. Another feature is that we have made a wire manager here, and you can slide in your cable from here, extension cable. So you can just open it, cable which is coming from your sensor. You can just slide it in and let it go inside. And then inside only you connect this with the camera interface cable so that the joint will be not exposed to all. Another thing which you have to careful is when you are putting it inside and then you are taking the cable, don't let it be going like up. Because suppose it is rain, then the water will follow this cable and might slip in. So try to keep it loose, and then or you just take a rotation, rotate around here. It should be going down and up wherever you are fixing it, so that water doesn't come along with the cable inside the box. Okay, so like that you can connect the cable through this wire manager. And inside you will have three pieces of foam. And the foam you will see which has already laser cut. So you can easily pick up wherever you want your camera space to be created. So what you do is, you have three pieces here, and the last piece is the thinnest one and it doesn't have any computer cut. So that you keep it inside and just take a marker, and from the lens opening you just mark where this opening will be coming into the foam. Then you take out the foam, you will know where exactly you have to start the cutting, but don't cut at the full size of the 95mm. Just put your lens over the within the circle and cut as per your the barrel size of the lens. So the lens should hold the foam, should hold the lens barrel, so it will again help in reducing the sound passing out of the camera box. Also, some of the time when you will not be using that front element, when you are sure that there is not going to be rain or for the short duration, very short duration you are using it, because you can avoid using another glass element in front of your lens. Sometimes also, if the foam is tightly holding your front and your lens, the sound will not be coming out. And once you have inner circle cut, align them outside, and then one by one you start picking up top, keep the pieces, and these are very easy to pluck it. You can see there are all those cubical shapes, cuts are there. And as per your camera size, keep taking out, but always take less than what is required. And once you put a camera, and let it be little tight inside so that it can hold your camera properly. So that's how you can create a space for your camera. And one more interesting thing is that we have provided an aluminum plate at the bottom. And you can see it. And it has a 1x4 1x4 inch threads, three of them. So you can mount most of the plates which have 1x4 thread into it. And if you have longer plates, you can use two threads, mounting threads, so that your plates will not rotate. And that's it. It can easily rip it. And then once you have the plate here, you can either mount on a tripod or a pole, whatever you are using into the plate. That's how your camera can just lock in with it. That's it, folks. This is the camera case, and subscribe if you have not subscribed, because we are coming up with some more videos about camera trap equipment. Thank you for watching.